Hey guys, Ronald here with Coastline Robotics. Today I'm going to show you how to flash the SP Racing F3 board for bridge motors by request of some people. They have sent me some emails asking how to do it, because sometimes it could be a little bit confusing, but it's actually pretty simple to do. So here we go. All right, so here is our brand new SP Racing F3 board for brush motors. And there is very little preparation required before you jump into the flashing process. So the first thing that you have to do is to locate these couple of pads that are very close to the motor number 4 and the UART number 3. As you can see here, it says boot. And it's these two little pads that are here. They'll need to be soldered together in order to access the bootloader of this board. And since we're gonna be using soldering, I'm just gonna solder the battery power cable on these two inputs here. So you can see battery positive and battery negative. Just make sure that you're connecting it properly. So make sure that you're not overheating any components around these boot pads. And yeah, just try to be as quick as possible. So here we go. Okay, done. Now I have my boot pads jumper. Next thing I'm gonna do is solder the battery power cable. So here we go with the positive. Looks. He has a very shiny and round finish. Okay, now we are ready to jump into the flashing process. Alright, so we are here in Cleanflight, and just as a demonstration, I'm gonna connect another board that I have without the pads, the bootloader pads solder, and as soon as you connect it, you're gonna see the virtual COM port and the number of the computer has created for your virtual COM port. So if I connect, you can see that I am on Cleanflight and I can manipulate this version of the firmware without any problem. Now if I go to the CLI and type dump command, I can see what version of a Cleanflight I have. So I have here the version 1.13, which was released in June the 6th of 2016. But what I want to have here in my board is not Cleanflight, what I want to have is Betaflight. Now I'm gonna disconnect this board. And if you try to flash the board without the bootloader solder or jumped, then it won't flash your board and you'll have some problems. So I won't even try that. I'll disconnect this. And now I'm gonna connect the board with the jump bootloader pads. As you can see, nothing happened. If I click connect, it won't connect. It will say fail to open serial port. And I'll have a steady red light on the board and no other light. Now the trick to flash this board is to download a program called Zadig from this website. I have attached a link in the description of the video. All you have to do is download it. I'm using Windows 10 and launch it. In the options, I'm gonna click list all devices. And from the drop-down menu, you should have this device called STM32 Bootloader. This only will come up if you have your pins, your bootloader pins, jumped. Otherwise, it won't work. Now I'll click on this, and as you can see, there's a different driver, but this is gonna be our target driver. So all I have to do is click replace driver, which I'm gonna do right now. It's gonna install the driver. And now it says that the driver was installed successfully. minimize this, and let's unplug the board, and let's plug it again. And as you can see, now we have a different indicator here, says DFU, and that's what we want, that's what we need if we want to flash our Betaflight firmware. I'm gonna close Cleanflight, and I'm gonna open Betaflight. I'm gonna go to the firmware flasher, I'm gonna choose my board, and I'm gonna select the appropriate firmware version that I want to flash on it. I'm gonna do it directly from online, so I'm just gonna click, we'll download and prepare the firmware, and all I have to do is flash firmware. It's flashing very fine, and now the programming was successful. If I come here, now I can connect my board, and now I have Betaflight 3.0 flash on my SP Racing for brush motors. And to demonstrate it, let's go to the CLI and type again dump. And now, happily, we have Betaflight SP Racing F3 EVO version 3.0. So after this, don't forget to desolder the bootloader pads. And if you need to flash the board again, all you have to do is jump these pads again. Now, that was it. I hope this little video will help you solve this problem. And also, as a bonus tip, this method can be used with other boards, let's say the Lux flight controller, or even the Keys flight controller. I know sometimes it doesn't allow you to flash if you don't have the DFU connection. I really hope you liked and enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like or comment if you like it, and I'll see you next time.